So folks, how's it going? This is Lodge. Hope you guys are all doing well. Here for a battery test comparison for you guys, comparing the new iPhone 7, which has a big battery improvement compared to the 6S, but of course isn't as good as the Samsung Galaxy S7. So here we're going to basically test out both smartphones and determine which one is best. But the first thing that we're going to start out with is the basic battery specifications of both devices. So the new iPhone 7 has a 1960 milliamp hour battery, which is a pretty big improvement from the 6S, which had around 1700 milliamp hour battery. So we're still using the Lightning connectivity. In fact, that's the only port that you have in the entire device. Unfortunately, no headphone jack, as you guys all know. In terms of overall charge times, you're looking at about 1 amp charging, about 165 minutes. Now, if you do use the 2 amp charger that comes with an iPad, you can reduce it down a little bit to about 115 minutes, going from 0 to 100% charge. Now, the S7 has a 3000 milliamp hour battery, which is non-user replaceable, just like the iPhone, and it's using a micro USB cable. Unfortunately, no USB Type-C like we have on the Note 7, but it does have quick charging capabilities, as well as wireless charging capabilities, both PMA and Qi wireless chargers. And you can get a full charge using the fast charger in just about 85 minutes, going from 0 to 100% charge. Now, the first thing I like to do to test out the battery life and to take out as many variables as possible, because that's always going to be a huge factor when testing out battery life in real life, is just do a simple video playback test. So what I like to do is use the VLC application on both iOS and Android. Just play the same video on both devices, turn off Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, crank up the backlight to 100%, and see how both devices fare up. Now, basically, here are the results over here. The iPhone 7 lasted about 13.2 hours, which is about 2 hours better than the 6S. But even with that improvement, it really can't compete against that larger battery, which the S7 has, and that got about 14.1 hours. So definitely a pretty significant difference between these two devices when it comes to overall video playback. Now, the second test that we're going to do is the GFX OpenGL benchmark using the battery life tool specifically. What this tests is an estimate of how long a high demanding CPU and GPU application will last on both devices, and how will your CPU and GPU handle after running a high demand application after a long period of time, so throttling performance as your temperatures go up in the device. So basically, this tool runs 30 iterations of the T-Rex benchmark built into the application, and it'll throw out two numbers at the end of the test. One will be an estimation of how long your battery will last. Another one will indicate the lowest amount of frames rendered in each iteration. So as your CPU and GPU and phone increases in temperature, will it actually decrease performance and overall efficiency? So beginning with the iPhone 7, the estimated battery life runtime is about 189 minutes, and the long-term performance score, so that's the weakest frames rendered in each of the 30 iterations, was about 3,190 frames rendered. Now, if you take a look at our Samsung Galaxy S7, the estimated battery life performance is very similar to the iPhone, about 188 minutes. Now, our long-term performance score at 2560 by 1440 is rated for about 1,339, which is not as high as obviously the iPhone, which has a lower resolution overall rendering display, so that's why we have a difference in terms of those two scores. That being said, if you take a look at the performance chart, you'll see that the Samsung deviates a lot more as the benchmark continues forward, perhaps because the efficiency is not as good and the temperatures rise up a little bit quicker than what we find on the iPhone. But really on that, guys, that's really it. Now, in terms of real-world battery performance, that's going to definitely fluctuate from person to person, depending on what kind of things you like to do with your smartphone on a day-to-day basis. Generally speaking, both smartphones shouldn't have any problems lasting throughout the day, regardless of most people's demanding needs. Obviously, the S7 at this standpoint definitely has the better overall battery performance because of that larger capacity, and the efficiency is not too bad. Computing-wise, I think the iPhone 7, being the newer device, has the newer hardware. It is faster when it comes to the GPU and CPU standpoint, But if you're in it for endurance and obviously a better display, definitely take a look at what other smartphones are being offered right now, such as the S7, which is definitely a fantastic overall device. Check out the speed test comparison between these two, as well as our 4K camera comparison if you haven't done so already. But thanks again for watching. Thanks for your support.